Okay, everybody, this is Soggy704, and this video, as you can see, I have two DualShock 4's here with me, and I wanted to talk about, as it says in the title of the video, about the wear and tear issues of the DualShock 4. And this is a problem, in my opinion, because, the PlayStation 4 and subsequently the controllers have only been out since November. And I am actually quite disappointed with the materials or the finish that they put on these things, because they wear off very quickly, and most people probably haven't noticed yet because you probably haven't been playing it enough for it to happen to you. But I can guarantee you it will, because I'm typically very good with my stuff. And I don't say that to pat myself on the back. It's just a fact. I don't throw my controllers around. I don't treat them with neglect or any other, or treat them roughly when I am using them. I just, it's a very normal. I press and use sticks with, care, but not like babying them necessarily. But I'm not trying to, be rough with them. And with these controllers, it's just something I've never experienced with any other official Sony controller ever before. So that's why I'm very disappointed. Because I've been with using PlayStation systems since the very beginning in 95, and still have that stuff around. And a lot of the cases, I still have many years old, PlayStation 3, PlayStation 2, PlayStation 1 controllers that still don't have this kind of issue, at least for me. And so I'm going to talk about that. Now, I have two of these DualShock 4s. Both are exhibiting the same issues, one more than the other, because I've used one more than the other, which is, this is one I've used the most, this is the second one I got, which I've used a little less, but it's still, they're both exhibiting the same issues, and this is why I'm very disappointed, and I hope that I hope Sony changes the way that they manufacture these so that they're more durable for these reasons in the future. And to get on with it, I'm going to show you the worst one I have, but I'm also going to show you both, really, because I want you to see that it's not like an isolated incident here. One of these controllers is, of course, from my actual system purchase, and then the other one is from the separate controller purchase later on. Or I should say, my separate controller purchase actually came before the system was even out, because for some reason I could get it at GameStop before the system was released. But whatever. That doesn't really matter. Now, as you can see, you can probably already see it right there on the touchpad. You can see there's clearly some wear on that. And that's from swiping. Okay. Now, the game I played by far the most on the PS4 is Warframe. And I mentioned that, I mentioned saying something about Warframe in the last video, my Pickus video. But that's a game I'm playing a lot. I've put in about 150 hours into it since December. And I have to say, this is pretty sad. Like this is their main thing that they're pushing with this controller, and it's, you can see, clearly see that wear and tear on it. And that's just from me swiping to do the Warframe powers. Each Warframe and Warframe has a power. It's four powers you can use. And you just swipe one of the cardinal directions on the touchpad to do them, if you have them equipped. And so it's just up, down, left, and right. And as you can see, I've been doing a lot with my... I'd always do it frequently with my right thumb. And as you can see, it's been doing a lot of right swipes because that's the direction you do for the ultimate, or the most destructive power, typically, the Warframe can do. So, but you can see, I've this is how I do it. I reach over and I just swipe like that, up, left, right, like that. And, I don't push on it hard, I don't do anything special, because obviously if I pressed, I would be pressing the button in. And in Warframe, pressing the touchpad button takes the minimap from the, that's in normally in the top left corner of the screen, and puts it, makes it bigger and puts it transparent in kind of like this center right of the screen. And you can, of course, toggle that as you see fit. But typically I don't even press that, I just use this for the Warframe powers, because that's what it's used for, and it's just doing it very lightly, as I always do, it's you can already see the wear and tear. It's actually very, where in this area here that you can see it, it's actually not smooth anymore. It's actually rough. It makes it harder to do the swipes now because of that. Not because it's less responsive. It's still just as responsive. It's just that because of its rougher texture now, where that is worn off, the finish, it now it's just harder for your thumb to move on it, as you'd expect. Whereas over here, where I've not touched much at all, it's still just as smooth as usual. So that's a worrying trend, because they are pushing this as a big deal, and I've already worn it out. It's pretty sad. The other one, that more people probably have noticed, because you tend to use this a lot more, and that's on the analog sticks. Especially the left stick, because that seems to be the one you use the most. Whereas my right sticks don't have it nearly as much of a problem, but still, obviously, it's going to be an issue, because it's the same material. And that, of course, is the rubber wearing down very quickly on these sticks. I don't know, this one's obviously going to be a lot harder to tell that I'm saying that is true, but I assume more people have already seen or already can tell. This is not a problem that's regulated just these controllers. You can get that to happen on like PlayStation 2 controllers, PlayStation 3 controllers, Xbox 360 controllers, but typically those seem to have rubber that where that just takes a lot longer and is much more acceptable, because it takes so much longer. I don't have that issue on most of my PlayStation controllers and other controllers I have for other systems, except for these. These, I was really shocked at how quickly this started wearing out and becoming smooth. It's not harder to control. I'm not really having much of a problem controlling still, but it's really obvious the way it feels and how that it's wearing down already. So that's also very disheartening. And then the last thing that's also wearing down on the finish is the face buttons. This is another one I can't really show you easily like I can the touchpad. But trust me, it's happening. Because in Warframe I use the square and triangle, I'm sorry, can't get this right, square and X buttons the most, the others are used, but they're just not used as much. So when I'm using these and I feel how they feel, compared to, like, say, these two, they still feel more worn down than they should, but they feel more like they did initially with their finish. Now, here, these don't. So, they just feel a lot rougher. Not a lot, I guess, but it's just a difference you can tell. You can definitely tell. The same as on this controller. This one doesn't feel as bad. This one feels a little bit better because it's obviously the one I've used less. And you can still see the wear and tear on the touchpad, even though it's less prominent. It's still there. It's still the same problem. And the same thing with the stick rubber and the finish on these face buttons. Luckily, everything else doesn't seem to be as much of a problem. At least doesn't seem to have an issue. I hope that that's the case. I don't want more issues, but the D-pad still feels good, though it may just be because I just don't use it as much as the others, which would be a shame. And the shoulder buttons and the triggers don't seem to have any issue with wear and tear, and they've been responsive and fine for me the whole time. So I just wanted to get that out there, that this is a real issue that I just think is unacceptable, considering the fact that these are not all that old. I don't treat them like crap. I've been using them a lot, but that shouldn't be an excuse, because I've used a lot of other PlayStation controllers in the past, I still have, and they're fine. So, yeah, Sony, you really need to correct this, because this is a huge problem. I shouldn't have to go out and get, like, thumbstick covers so that I can have grip again, you know, or just prevent these from wearing out more. And what do I do about the face buttons, you know? We're going to have to start having covers for those, too. I mean, it's just ridiculous. And then what about this? What about the touchpad? What am I going to do about that? You know what I'm saying? This is a huge problem. I mean, who's to say that later on down the road, the touchpad's just not going to respond anymore in those areas that you used it most? So, that's a huge problem, because, you know, especially in games like Warframe, where those superpowers, as I mentioned, with the touchpad, is the only way to do it. You can't map it in a way that I'm aware of, because every other button on those controllers used for that game. So, well, except the D-pad. So I suppose you could do it there, but if they let you map it. But I don't think they do. But regardless, It's ridiculous. So, just want to let everyone know. I don't know. I don't know of any way to prevent this. It's just, I don't see how you could possibly prevent it, because I haven't, like I said, haven't been using this in any fashion that's out of the ordinary, and I'm not being abusive to it. So, it's a problem that needs to be fixed, and I really, really, Sony needs to use better materials and better finishes or coating or whatever the fuck any of this stuff is, because this is just ridiculous. So, thanks for watching, everyone.